That's right, Amanda. We're working for you to find out how did this happen and what does it mean. Now, we can tell you there are three different ITT Tech locations in Indianapolis. All three are closed. Now, the location here in the 2500 block of Shadeland Avenue, lights are off and the doors are locked. The parking lot of the location not far from 96 in Michigan, same thing, completely empty. The location in the 13,000 block of Meridian and Carmel, also closed today. Now, this comes on the heels of a federal ruling blocking all federal student loan funding for ITT Tech. The U.S. Department of Education said that ITT Tech had been the subject of numerous state and federal investigations and that there had been concerns about issues like its financial viability and its ability to serve its students. Now, ITT Tech says actions of and sanctions from the U.S. Department of Education forced it to cease operations. The school released a statement saying, "We believe the government's action was inappropriate and unconstitutional. However, with the ITT Technical Institute ceasing operations, it will now likely rest on the parties of others to understand the reprehensible actions and to take action to attempt to prevent this from happening again." One student we talked to said she is devastated.
"I'm unemployed. I'm on food stamps. I'm probably one of the people that shouldn't have had a loan, but they gave me one. I was so grateful."
Now, that student we talked to said she had just successfully completed her first semester and was looking forward to starting the second semester that would have started next week. That is now not going to happen. Now, as far as what comes next, we have learned that, for example, that student didn't even know about it until she heard it on the news. Now, ITT Tech is sending out letters to its students notifying them about the closure. We tried to reach out to ITT Tech by phone. We just got voicemails. So what is next? If you want to know, go to our mobile app on WRTV6 to see what to do if you have student loans or maybe if you're one of those employees. Reporting live on the Northeast side, Julie Persley, WRTV6.